Karbala, we're coming, walking because in our rising is priceless. Walking because anything else is worthless. Walking because anything else is worthless. 40 days and counting.
His 40th comes, and the heavens hear a call. Descends on Karbala, each lover and angel. The father leaves behind his wife, children and all. The mother carries the children that barely crawl. Men swear by their women, women by their children. No death on this road will bring to us distress. Walking, because anything else is worthless.
40 days and counting.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين إلى قيام يوم الدين. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. In regards to understanding the divinity and the greatness behind the ziyarah of Sayyid al-Shuhada Aba Abdullah al-Hussein, I would like to share with you a narration which is taken from the book Kamilu Ziyarat, authored by Sheikh Ibn Kawlaway in 367 AH. Kamilu Ziyarat, as per the attestation of the author himself and a number of the Maraja over the last few generations, have all attested to the credibility and the authenticity of this book. The title of the book is Kamilu Ziyarat, authored by Ibn Kawlaway in 367 AH. So as a text, this is a text which dates back to almost 1,000 years, if not more than that. Within this book, there is a hadith narrated by Ishaq ibn Ammar, one of the companions of our sixth Imam al-Sadiq, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, where he says, سَمِعْتُ أَبَا عَبْدِ اللَّهِ يَكُولُ. يعني, Ishaq ibn Ammar is saying, I heard Imam al-Sadiq say, لَيْسَ نَبِي فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ إِلَّا وَيَسْأَلُونَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى أَنْ يَعْدِنَ لَهُمْ فِي زِيَارَةِ الْحُسَيْنِ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ فَفَوْجٌ يَنْزِلْ وَفَوْجٌ يَسْعَدْ. He goes on to say that there is not a single prophet within the heavens except that they seek permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to perform the ziyarah of Sayyid al-Shuhada Aba Abdullah al-Husayn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the permission. And there are ranks and ranks of prophets descending down to perform the ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn as other prophets are rising back to the heavens upon the completion of the ziyarah. From this particular narration, we understand, number one, that even the anbiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those 124,000 prophets without exception, seek permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to perform the ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn in Karbala. فَإِنْتَ جَنَابَكَ. You want to be in the ranks of Adam, you want to be in the ranks of Nuh, you want to be in the ranks of Nabi Ibrahim, you want to be in the ranks of Nabi Isa, you want to be together with Nabi Musa, you want to be with Rasulullah, make this ziyarah to Imam al-Husayn. For indeed, you are amongst those human beings and those individuals together with the Anbiya who shall perform the visitation of Imam al-Husayn. Furthermore, when you contemplate over this tradition, I ask you, brothers and sisters, what is better, life on the dunya or life in Jannah? Perhaps you will say, that the answer is very simple. And the life in Jannah, to stay in Jannah, is much better and not even comparable to life in the dunya. But the exception to this rule is the land of Karbala. The Anbiya, all of them are in heavens, but each and every one of the Prophet wants to leave the heavens to come down to the earth in Karbala to perform the ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn. Fahaniyan, congratulations and blessings be upon those individuals who are making this trip, sacrificing from their time and their wealth to visit the Master of Freedom, Aba Abdullah al-Husayn, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, wa salamun alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I see a young girl and it is like she is holding. She reminds me of Ruqayya. I start crying. I see a woman at the roadside. She's standing. She reminds me of Zainab for Abbas waiting. She stands there on her own and cries even hearts of stone. She stands there on her own. Cries, even hearts of stone. The tears that flow, watching these things are endless. Walking because anything else is worthless. Walking because anything else is worthless.
40 days and counting.
Upon this road whilst walking I learnt a lesson. Never look back when Hussein's your destination. I have Hussein, therefore nothing else is my concern. Be by me or don't be, to my beloved I return. Catch up or lag behind. By Hussein, me, you'll find. My life belongs to him. He isn't worthless. Walking because anything else is worthless.
40 days and counting.
When with the millions on his grave I descend, I'll say I walk all this way to a new peace. And the beauty of this walk only you comprehend. And I will return each year until my life's end.
Till Allah عذب الله. حب الوصي وغذتني باللبن لا عذب الله.
I'm now standing in the vicinity of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ali is the one who brought down the gates of Khaybar. Ali ibn Abi Talib is the lion of God. Ali is known to be father of the orphans. It is said that if we were told everything, all the qualities about Amir al-Mu'mineen, we would believe he was God. For that reason, we were only told a fraction, a small fraction of what he truly was. Ya Ali, when you call it out, all your worries are gone. When you call out Ya Ali, you have no worries.
عذب الله أمي. إنها
begin the walk inshallah to Karbala and you'll be embarking on a journey that you will never forget your entire life, a journey that you will tell your children and grandchildren about, the journey of the walk to salvation, the walk to freedom, the walk to Abi Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam.
Walking because anything else is worthless. Walking because anything else is worthless.
40 days and counting.
The call of the man that serves Karbala's water. Drink Abu Ali's water and curse Harmala. Fatima watches, of who do we remind her? Qasim, Layla, Abdullah and Ali al-Akbar. Both the young and the old. Every hand her hand holds. She breathes breath into the one that is breathless. Walking because anything else is worthless.
40 days and counting. Karbala, we're coming. 40 days and counting. Karbala, we're coming. Walking because in our eyes he is priceless. Walking because anything else is worthless. Walking because anything else is worthless.
He who serves us food, who does he see behind him? He sees on his feet pouring the food. Is Qasim when they reach Karbala's border? Who welcomes them? Abbas cries out, O servants of Hussein, welcome! His brothers by his side, his mother cries in pride. His brothers by his side, his mother cries in pride. Abbas, bring me one of their children to kiss. Walking because anything else is worthless. Walking because anything else is worthless.
40 days and counting. Karbala, we're coming. 40 days and counting.
قصه که همه آقایون خوب میدونن شنیدن، خیلی از آقایون ده ها بار خوندن، قصه در خورد حضرت شهدا صلوات الله و سلام علیه با حر و اصحابش تو راه کربلا. حر و اصحابش محارب نبودن. امام معصوم آقا حضرت سید شهدا صلوات الله و سلام علیه هزار مسلح به ریاست حر اومده. کارشون چی بود؟ وظیفه‌شون این بود، مأموریتشون این بود که آقا حضرت سید شهدا رو ببرن تسلیم ابن زیاد کنن. اعلام هم کردن برای آقا حضرت سید شهدا این وظیفه و این مأموریت ما اینه. از اظهر مصادیق محارب، از اظهر مصادیق بغات، از اظهر مصادیق خوارج، از اظهر مصادیق نواصل. شبهه هست؟ شکی هست درش؟ چرا مسلح هم هستن؟ که آقا اگه امتناع کردن دست به شمشیر بزنن به جنگ. مأموریت این بود با جنگ هم که شده حضرت رو ببر. برای حضرت هم اعلام کردن. حضرت دیدن تشنه هستن آبشون داد. این قصه کوچیک نیست. همین قصه و امثال اینها من و شما را امروز شیعه قرار داده، نگهداری کرده و در طول تاریخ گذشته و آینده هزارها میلیارد مؤمن شیعه متدین مال همین چیز هست. و رشف و خیلی ترشیف و انگار برادر عزیزه. بعدم یکیشون نمیتونه آب بخوره، خود آقا پیاده ایشن. برای آقا مسئله نی، اینا مطلب نی. به این آب بدن یا به اون آب بدن، مطلب اینه چی؟ اسلام را تو نظر مردم جلوه میده. بیان دنبال اسلام، سعادت دنیا گیرشون میاد، سعادت آخرت گیرشون میاد.
The 40 pilgrimage this year will witness the participation of over 50 foreign Husseini processions speaking various languages, in addition to the approximate 8,000 services processions along the way to Karbala city. Head of the Processions and Rituals Department of Iraq indicates the participation of processions from the United States of America, Canada, Britain, Sweden, Germany, Denmark, Russia, India, Iran, Pakistan, Bahrain, Saudi Arabia, Afghanistan, Azerbaijan and Turkey, providing various medical, accommodation, food and comforting services for the pilgrims of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Translators and guides will also be present to aid the pilgrims in their journey towards paradise. What is so magnificent yet beautiful at the same time are the 24/7 services which are provided to the pilgrims free of charge during the 20 days leading up to the Arba'een. The individual serving pull the pilgrim to massage their body, to give them hundreds of different types of food, polish their shoes and wash their clothes. We are not talking about a small group of people. Last year approximately 25 million pilgrims entered Karbala. This number is equal to the inhabitants of 25 small countries such as Bahrain, Kuwait, Oman and Qatar. Managing and controlling such a number in a small city like Karbala is nothing but a miracle.
So I stand here in front of Mokib Khaymat Abdullah al-Radiya, the camp of Abdullah al-Radiya, who was a six-month child of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, who was martyred on the plains of Karbala. In any case, this Mokib, the reason why there's so much people around here is that this mokib offers a different type of menu than the usual mokib around. They offer grilled chicken with bread. And like I said before, you can see that the volunteers are wearing orange and black. And what I'm told, that they are from different nationalities, be it Bahrain, Syria, Lebanon. They've all come together to offer what little they can in terms of service for Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Inshallah, we're going to get a bit more of a closer inside and maybe have an interview with one of the coordinators of this Mokib to see the reasoning behind their service for Imam Hussein alayhi salam and why they offer something so unique in this type of way, inshallah. So alhamdulillah, we've been granted permission to enter through the Mokib to see how exactly they function and how exactly they bring all of the meals together. On my left hand side, you can see that the meat is being prepared by not just one, two, three people. I think there's almost 50 to 60 people here working around the clock to make sure all of the meals are prepared. All the meals are prepared for the visitors of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. You'll be able to see that there's a man wielding a knife who's cutting what seems to be shawarma, which is an Iraqi delicacy here. And there's minced meat, there's all kinds of meat for the visitors of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. بس حبيت اسال هاي موكب ايش وقت اسست؟ صار لها كم سنه هنا؟
2006
وكم واحد يشتغل وياك؟
80
شخص من يا بلد؟
البلد من السعوديه 80 من السعوديه
80 من السعوديه
80 من ايران بس الايرانيين مقسمين على موكب المكايه
تحصيل
اللي هنا كلهم من السعوديه 80 من السعوديه من المنطقه الشرقيه القطيف
القطيف اوكي سو I speak to one of the coordinators. He tells me that there's approximately 80 people that are working here now, but most of them are from Saudi Arabia, from the Qatif region, the Qatif region. And he also says there are some people from other Mawakib who also come here from Iran. So you have both Saudis and Iranians who have come here today. وانتو من يايوم الى يايوم خدموا الزوار.
من تاريخ 7
صفر.
ان شاء الله.
يعني ليلة ورا البعض.
25 صفر يعني من ناخذ بعد الاربعينية.
4 ايام ما شاء الله. تحسبون العدد اللي تعطون
لا والله نفس الدجاج اللي نسويه، في اليوم نسوي لنا مثلا من بداية الايام نسوي 2000 دجاج.
2000 دجاج.
نسوي الكباب تقريبا ما يقارب 5000.
نعم.
الان الشاورما اليوم بدينا فيها 400 كيلو الان
400 كيلو ان شاء الله
اليوم كله
ان شاء الله ف 2000 دجاج و 5000 قطعه كباب
قطعه
كباب و 400 كيلو
400 كيلو شاورما
So from what he's been telling me in terms of the actual meal preparations here, they cook approximately 2,000 chickens. These chickens are probably, you know, spliced into 4 or 5 or given out for the zuwar. So 2,000 chickens, 5,000 pieces of kebab, and today they've introduced 400 kilograms of meat for shawarma, which is great to see. So again, more information that has been given to me by one of the coordinators. He tells me that the main chefs that actually cut and cook the meats are Iranians. And even the bread makers, the people that make Jaffa bread, they are also Iranian. But the workers here are Saudi Arabian that come from the Qatif region. So this big massive pot of chicken, it's frozen chicken. What they do is they put water in it and they heat it up so that it becomes ready for grilling or ready for cooking later on, inshallah. They've also taken with them, so with it, from Saudi Arabia, they bought fridges, as he told me. Somewhere in the back here are big fridges. Oh, these. So these two are big fridges that they keep all the meat in. And you can show me, yeah, it's absolutely cold here as well. So this is where all the meat is kept. Fresh and ready for the zuwar of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam.
جمالا يوسفيا ونبعا كوثريا
تركنا الخلق طرا واتينا وذبنا فيك حبا مذرعينا جمالا يوسفيا ونبعا كوثريا
Karbala, we're coming, walking because it's
I see a young girl and a flag she is holding. She reminds me of Ruqayya. I start crying. I see a woman at the roadside. She's standing. She reminds me of Zainab for Abbas waiting. She stands there on and on, cries even hearts of stone. She stands there on and on, cries even hearts of stone. The tears that flow, watching these things are endless. Walking because anything else is worthless. Walking because anything else is worthless.
40 days and counting, Karbala we're coming. 40 days and counting,
اللهم إني أشهدك إني ولي لمن والى وعدو لمن عادى بأبي أنت وأمي يا ابن رسول الله أشهد أنك كنت نورا في الأصلاب شامخا والأرحام المطهرة لم تنجسك الجاهلية بأنجاسها ولم تلبسك المدلهمات من ثيابها وأشهد أنك من دعائم الدين وأركان المسلمين ومعقل المؤمنين وأشهد أنك الإمام البر التقي الرضي الزكي الهادي المهدي